Did you know? As critically acclaimed as the Legend of Zelda games are, the series has its fair share of mistakes. In A Link to the Past, there's an item called the Cane of Somaria, which has an interesting story surrounding its name. When the game was ported to Game Boy Advance, the item was renamed Cane of Somasoa, but only in the Japanese version. Professional game translator Clyde Mendelin looked into why the name was changed, and documented any differences between the various releases of the game. The re-releases on the Wii and Wii U Virtual Console, as well as the release on the SNES Classic, call the item Cane of Somaria in English and Japanese. Mendelin even checked the version from the Japanese Super Famicom service, Nintendo Power. This now-defunct service allowed people to download Super Famicom titles onto a blank cartridge at the fraction of the retail price. The item in this version of A Link to the Past still had the Somaria name. However, the item is named differently in the GBA's game's various Japanese strategy guides. Both Famitsu and Nintendo's Dream Magazine guides referred to the item as Cane of Somaria, with only Nintendo's official guide referring to the item as Somasoa. The word Somaria and the word Somasoa are very similar in Japanese. This is because the katakana for Ri and So are visually alike, especially in A Link to the Past game front. It seems that while developing the GBA port, a member of the staff either misread or miswrote the Cane's name as Somasoa. This mistake must have stuck, and made it into the game's retail release. The very first Zelda game on the NES has a number of grammatical errors and translation issues. The English game's opening text was lifted straight from the Japanese version, which was written entirely in English. In it, the Triforce of Power and Wisdom are referred to as the Triforce with Power and Wisdom. Ganon's name is also misspelled with an extra N. The spelling of Ganon was also present in the Famicom Disc version of Zelda 2, and the Japanese version of A Link to the Past. The English and Japanese versions of the original Zelda have several re-releases, with minor revisions to them. The opening script was revised in 2003 for the Zelda Collection on the GameCube, which fixed spelling errors in the message. However, most of the in-game text is still far from perfect, with odd wording and cryptic hints. There's one spelling error that managed to slip through the cracks time and time again. The hint man in the first level talks about an eastern peninsula, but the word peninsula was again spelled with an extra N. Despite the changes made to the other spelling errors, this mistake popped up in the GBA port. It also occurred in the Zelda Collection as well as the Virtual Console release for the Wii, Wii U, and Nintendo 3DS. It wasn't until the release of the NES Classic in 2016 when it was finally spelled correctly, nearly 30 years later. Developer oversights also led to the game's second quest mode, which essentially lets players replay the entire game with a few changed elements. In it, Iwata asks on the history of handheld Zelda games, designer Takashi Tezuka revealed he mistakenly only used half of the game's memory when making the game's dungeons. Zelda creator Shigeru Miyamoto saw this as an opportunity, and the team used the remaining memory to house the second quest. Nintendo veteran Toshihiko Nakago explained what happened when Tezuka gave him the first game's dungeon layout. Tetsukiya-san said, "I did it and brought this to me. I created the data exactly in line with it. But then, Tetsukiya-san made a mistake and only used half the data. I said, 'Tetsukiya-san, there's only half here. Where did the other half go?' And he was like, 'What? Oops. I messed up." Other releases of the game had even more spotty translation work, if any translation at all. In Europe, the first Zelda retained all English in-game text for most territories. Some versions left the text from the instruction manual untranslated, which likely left some players completely in the dark. This is somewhat addressed in the French release of Zelda 2. The game's manual came in French and featured translation for the in-game text, as some of it was still in English. However, the manual itself still had its fair share of mistranslations and errors. On top of this, not every line of dialogue in game was in the book, including important text the player needs to get through the game. In Minish Cap, the player is able to buy figurines, depicting characters and locations throughout the game. In the European PAL version, the figurine of the Ice Wizard Robe enemy tells the player to use the Fire Rod item on them, as they're weak to fire-based attacks. While the Fire Rod does exist in the game's code, it was ultimately cut from the final product, and their true weakness is in the Flame Lantern. When the game released in North America, a couple months later, this information was fixed. Another example of a figurine giving false information is found in the Spear Moblin figurine. It states the Spear Moblin goblins can appear in the Minish Woods, though they actually can't be found there at all. Mistakes in Zelda games have even started urban legends. In A Link to the Past, there were rumors of an invisible enemy found in the Dark World Swamp of Evil, alternatively known as Misery Mire. If the player heads to the southern area of the swamp and uses the Bamos Medallion, they may be able to see the enemy catch fire and leave an item behind. Players were unsure of what this invisible enemy might have been for years, leading to the enemies being named the Ghost of Misery Mire. It wasn't until the rise of ROM hacking when the mystery was finally uncovered. A ROM editor by the name of Hyrule Magic was released in the early 2000s and unveiled everything in this game's code, including the supposed ghosts. The code reveals that they're actually Fireball Zoras, enemies that do appear in the swamp and go by the name Ku in the Dark World. The oversight leading to the ghost came from A Link to the Past's water. The water can be found in two varieties, shallow and deep, with a specific type of Zora, or Ku, appearing in each. However, Ku were only programmed to appear in deep water, and several Ku in the swamp spawn in shallow water. Because the Ku are placed on tiles with properties they were never meant to spawn on, they were not properly rendered in game. It's believed that these Ku have either misplaced spawn points or were originally in deep water, which was changed to shallow water later in development. Either way, their presence in the final game is surely a mistake. The Zelda games on the Nintendo 64 have a myriad of glitches, and a few details that were overlooked during development. A recurring oversight can be found in the pots of Ocarina of Time. The twins' house in the Kokiri Forest may show one pot in the background, but the collision model actually features two. Due to how the background is mapped to this collision, if Link tries to roll between the pots, parts of him will disappear behind the background, where the hidden pot is located. The guardhouse in Hyrule Castle also has data for two pots that are missing. In the Water Temple's room with the timed geyser houses three unloaded pots, indicating that this room went through a redesign with pots being left out. Having used the same engine as Ocarina of Time and being developed in only 18 months, Majora's Mask shares a lot of similar glitches and oddities with its predecessor. It also reused many assets seen in Ocarina, but not every one of them made a perfect transition. The game's quest status screen has an unused item slot, for example, which in Ocarina was used for a golden Skatula icon. The text on the Romani's Ranch arc reads, "Welcome to Kakariko Village," when translated. This is because the arc was lifted right out of Ocarina of Time's corresponding area, and was fixed on the Majora's Mask remake on 3DS. Another oversight on Majora's Mask allows players to get more items for less money. If the player purchases an item in Majora's Mask, their rupee counter will tick down instead of immediately dropping. This isn't just a visual transition, however. It reflects the game's internal rupee counter. Because of this, players can buy more items than they should be able to. For example, if the player has 50 rupees and bought bombs for 30 rupees, if they managed to spam the A button and click purchase again before the rupee ticker went below 30, they could buy a second set of bombs. Majora's Mask also housed a version of the infamous bottle dupe glitch, which allowed players to overwrite items assigned to the C button with a bottle. In one of the easier methods of pulling this off, players needed to catch something in a bottle, such as a fish, then go to the curiosity shop. When giving an item to the merchant, the player needs to hold the R button while pressing the A button to confirm the exchange, then quickly bring up the items menu by pausing and switch out the bottle with items of their choice. After the exchange has finished, the player will have an empty bottle in place of their old item. This glitch was also initially present in the 3DS remake, before getting patched out 2 weeks after its release. While the glitch is able to make certain tasks in-game easier, it's just as easy to permanently lose an important item through it, like the hookshot. Speaking of lost items, the Thunder Helm in Breath of the Wild can be permanently lost if it's received when the armor inventory is full. After getting the helmet from Riju, the game will register Link as having the taken item, but it won't show up in Link's inventory with no way to get it back. The game does have an effect in place to try and stop this from happening, pretending the player hasn't done the side quest required to get it if they don't have the space for it. But if the game is saved and reloaded several times, the scene may progress like normal, leading to the glitch. The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword also has its share of mistakes. The ancient robots all have model numbers that relate to the Lanayru Desert, with these numbers starting with LD. The LD stands for the Lanayru Desert, and different regional versions of Skyward Sword have different abbreviations in line with the area's name, such as Japan, which uses RS for Renuyu Subaku. However, in this game's continuity, the robots were created before this area became a desert. When these robots were made, the area was a woodland by the sea. This means that any abbreviation referencing the desert doesn't make sense when the age of the robots is taken into account. Did you also know that Ocarina of Time and Super Mario 64 originally ran on the same game engine? Or that the Ocarina of Time swordplay is heavily inspired by the combat of Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link? For more facts, check out Did You Know Gaming's video on Ocarina of Time. My name is Lady Pelvic of Pelvic Gaming. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And be sure to check out my review of 1986's The Legend of Zelda. Thanks for watching!